take off running into this cell block. We come in, if you'll notice, they secure this door, they secure these doors, somebody will get the last door on the end. We secure all the cell doors. A detention deputy comes in behind, deadbolt locks all those cell doors. Now, the situation is under control to an extent, but what we've got inmates in these different cell block or cell houses that don't belong now. They just rushed to wherever they could get away once they saw that we were going to actually take some action. And again, this is not something we'd like to do, but we have to have order and control in the jail. It's imperative. Once we allow control, or once we lose control of a jail, then there's an opportunity for these inmates to get hurt. And it's an opportunity for our jailers to get hurt. And so that's why we took the action we did. This was not a riot situation. It was just a failure to comply with a lawful order. If we allowed these type situations to happen and not address them, I believe they could turn into riot situations. But this was not, and we were very fortunate. What they're doing, they're going in and they're handcuffing each individual inmate, and they're bringing every one of them out, and they're going to put them out here on the floor. See, officers are going checking each one, make sure that they are secured, make sure no one has weapons on them. You want to go ahead and get all the, I'll leave this showing, it'll show us laying about a dozen or so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay. After they're all laid out, and I'll show you on the video in just a moment, but this other door, after we get everyone out of these three cell blocks, we take each cell block at a time, we'll get them secured.
Where was the door that got ripped off the wall?
It was in another cell block. It was an unrelated incident.
Oh, okay.
Now, when they get everyone out, they're going to stack up on the second door. We're going to go through and do the same process. We're going to go in, take out however many inmates are in there. They yell through the door and tell them they need to be face down on the ground. Yeah. We had two or three inmates in the entire group that failed to comply. And then we were 36 inmates we were dealing with.
In this room? In this cell block?
In these cell block, yes. We had 36 total inmates. Cell block 3 is a large dormitory style cell block, and I'll show you that in just a moment. Once we get them all secured here, we go over into the adjacent cell block, which at that time was unlocked, and they were giving their lockdown orders. And again, there was about 9 hours of video. So what we pulled out is the actual incident, you know, not all the time where we were just waiting.
Right.
And we pulled out where you can actually see what happened with these inmates. You see these inmates are coming out, and they're complying.